Hey, what's up YouTube? This is Rakesh from Popingo, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to convert a raster image into a vector image. Yeah, that's what you read in the title. If you're wondering why should I even convert an image from a raster format to a vector format, I've made a separate video on explaining what's the difference between a raster image and a vector image. Do check that out by clicking the I button on the top right corner of the video or refer the description of the video. I've left the link to that video there. Alright, let's jump straight into the topic. So let me open an image that I've already stored, and I'll also reduce the size so that you can see it clearly. Okay, so this is the image that we are working on today. So in order to start converting this raster image to a vector image, hold Ctrl and click on the icon here. Select any of the selections tool, maybe I'll select lasso tool, and right click on the image where you can see make work path. Click on that and set the tolerance level here to 1 pixels. Make sure you set it to 1 pixels, that'll give the better results for us. And then as soon as you do that, go to paths and see there's a work path selected. So if you're not able to see the paths here, you can enable it by going to window and selecting the paths. Mine is already checked in. So let's go back to layers after creating a path, and then select the adjustment layer and select solid color. I'll just retain it with a black. As soon as you create an adjustment layer, notice there is a vector image created already. So now let's move this to the right so that you can compare it easily. The one in the left side is a raster image and the one in the right side is a vector image. So what is the difference? Let me zoom in to explain you the difference. So as I zoom in, can you see the difference already? In the raster image, you can see the blurry lines, but in the vector image, the lines are crystal clear. And another advantage with the raster image is no matter how much you resize the image is still going to retain the crispness. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you learned something new today. If you like this video, hit that thumbs up button, and if you want to see more such videos, subscribe to our channel. Have a good learning experience. See ya.